We are here at the American College of Thessaloniki with Maria Spazian. Hello.
Hello.
And welcome. Would you like to tell us a little bit about your presentation?
Well, today we're going to go through some of the methodological approach for language teaching and examine what we don't like about them anymore, but at the same time, what can be kept and how they can be used in the modern classroom along with other 21st century tools. So it's more about going down the memory lane of ELT methodology history, but at the same time looking at it with a different eye, how we can transform it, how we can combine it.
That's very interesting. Could you tell us how exactly the attendees, the teachers that are going to come to that talk of yours, how will they benefit? How can they use your suggestion?
I feel that most of us, having been trained in the 90s, and even colleagues who are just entering the profession, we feel that we have to choose one approach. We have to be either there or there. It's A or B, black or white. And everything in learning goes towards blending, combining, pick and choose, mix and match, like accessories.
Very good.
But in order to do that, you need to know what you're picking, what you're matching, what you're mixing. So I thought that these can be used. Okay, I will admit it's quite theoretical, but I've tried to put a practical element into it. And my idea is not to focus on the criticism and the things that seem odd to us about these methods, but actually what can be kept and how it can be used. So I think this is the practical thing that the colleagues will take away.
Very good. I think that's going to be very, very interesting for everyone.
Hopefully.
It will be. Certainly will be. So can you give us some highlights of the conference so far?
Oh, I think it's been a wonderful conference. I've enjoyed seeing so many people, and we've had brilliant plenary speakers. Obviously, the board should be congratulated on getting so many people from abroad, and they've done excellent plenaries. I've enjoyed everything. I've enjoyed the sessions and the plenaries, obviously, and it's been a great networking opportunity, I think. So yeah, it's been one of the best conferences ever.
For all of us, I fully agree with you. And one last question. You are a conference speaker.
Yep.
Yes. Would you like to share some of your experience with us? How is it? What does it feel like?
Nerve-wracking and mutually rewarding.
Okay.
It's one of the forces that drive teachers to be self-reflective, collect ideas, and at the same time dig into the bibliography and study. So I think that everybody does me a favor because they come and listen to me talking about the things that I've studied, which helped me a lot.
Right.
And I hope I'm helpful to others as well.
So would you recommend it?
I would definitely recommend. I think what we need more than anything is the voice of the practicing teacher. The theory is there, and there are people who teach tertiary level and people who teach linguistics, or they're teacher trainers by profession. What we need, though, is the voice of the teacher who goes in and out the classroom every day, no matter what, and has an intuitive lesson plan that caters for different learning needs. And if I may say that, I was very happy because one of my friends, who is a practicing teacher, had her first presentation yesterday.
Good.
And it was amazing to see the wealth of activities that she brought with her.
Excellent. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Christina, and for your hard work and all the other people.
For all the other reporters.
The roving reporters for covering the conference.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.